today we would be seeing radiological features of scurvy and rickets. So scurvy is basically deficiency of vitamin C, because of which hydroxyproline is not formed, therefore collagen is not formed, therefore the bone matrix is weak. So it leads to osteoporosis. One of the previously asked MCQs, it leads to osteoporosis. What we see the findings in radiology are, there is this white line of Frankel. You see the white line, that is a dense zone of provisional calcification. Just adjacent to it, towards the shaft, we see this lucent or black line, which is called the scorbutic zone or the tremor field zone. This white line, it extends to the corner, then it is called Pelkin's spur. So that is the Pelkin's spur at the metaphysis. So these are all metaphysis findings. Wimberger's ring is the one which is seen in epiphysis. Important to remember, the epiphyseal sign of scurvy is Wimberger's ring. So the epiphysis itself is not white, but it only has a sclerotic or white margin. So that is the Wimberger's ring. Next is, the cortex is very thin, like you have a thin lining surrounding the epiphysis. Even the cortex is thin, pencil thin cortex. And because of the capillary fragility, there are subperiosteal hemorrhages leading to periosteal elevation. So these are the findings of scurvy. If we see this on radiograph, so number one is this white line of Frankel. Then we see this lucent zone, that is the tremor field zone. This is the Wimberger's ring, the white line surrounding the epiphysis. And this is the pencil thin cortex. Coming to the next, now this is again an image of scurvy where we see this white line of Frankel, we see this Wimberger's ring and the Pelkin's spur. Now this is an image of rickets. Rickets is basically vitamin D deficiency. The first sign radiologically is this widening of the growth plate or the provisional zone of calcification. So there is a widening of the growth plate. There is this irregular margins of the metaphysis, which is called fraying. Now, because the bones are weak, when there is weight bearing on the bones, they splay out. They spread out, that is, there is splaying. So there is splaying and there is cupping. This concavity here is the cupping. This flaring out is the splaying. And the irregular margins, that is fraying. So the signs of rickets are fraying, splaying and cupping of metaphysis with widening of the growth plate. Remember that very important point, the white line of Frankel is not seen in active rickets but in healing rickets. So when the child is treated, the first treatment effect is seen by taking x-rays and we look for the white line of Frankel, which is seen in healing rickets, while the white line of Frankel is seen in active scurvy.